I have a condition called relapsing polychondritis. It's an autoimmune disease that affects multiple organs. It's usually known to affect mainly the nose and the ear, but it actually affects many more organs. For example, I had lung involvement and tracheal involvement, and it's a very difficult diagnosis to make of relapsing polychondritis, is because it's a clinical diagnosis. There are no biomarkers, meaning that there is not a blood test that can diagnose my disease. And then on top of that, it causes relapsing because the symptoms come and go. Sometimes the blood tests that are usually abnormal in somebody with inflammatory process could be completely normal in a patient with relapsing polychondritis despite significant inflammation, which is exactly what happened to me. So I was very sick for several years, on and off, but my labs were always normal, so I was thinking everything should be okay. And I feel extremely lucky that I was here at NIH when I got very, very sick. Because I'm a doctor, my husband is a doctor, my sister, my brother-in-law, my father, they're all doctors, and nobody could come up with the diagnosis. It was James Katz from NIAMS here at NIH who made the diagnosis. I was not able to walk for over a month because of the difficulty breathing and the significant swelling and pain on my knees. But I'm taking a combination treatment that is very novel for my disease. Research is the main element that we can have to help patients with all diseases. We currently are working combining efforts with multiple investigators here at NIH, and hopefully in the near future we will be able to study relapsing polychondritis in a systematic way. We have to figure out what is the mechanism of the disease and the possible genetic associations, and that is going to lead us to provide the patients with better treatment. So where there is research, there is hope.